Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing certain details about death of a partner, what are the important categories that we have to understand when the death of partner arises, and how to solve the problems related to it. The first thing that we'll be studying under death of a partner is that there is a very common similarity that we have to understand whenever retirement is dealt with and a debt is dealt with. So, if you are dealing with the death of a partner, the same thing has to be dealt in the case of retirement of a partner. So, whatever you have dealt whenever a partner retires, the only similar things have to be followed in the case of death as well. Except one more point needs to be added, that is the case of joint life policy. Because at the time of a death of a partner, whatever amount he is supposed to receive is supposed to be given to the executor of that specific partner. That means the legal heir of that specific partner. There will be given all the privileges, all the interest and etc. amount that is due to this partner at the agreed rate, or if the rate is not given, then it is by default at 6% per annum is supposed to be provided to the executor of this partner. Now, in the first scenario that you have to understand is that the joint life policy which is taken into consideration. So, retirement and death. Under these both scenarios, you will have this specific life policy will be taken under consideration. So the first thing that we'll be studying here is the separate life transaction or the special transaction case. Under this category will be named as death of a partner, separate or joint life policy. Now let's understand special transaction for joint life policy first. Now, when we are dealing with death of a partner, we are dealing with a special transaction named as joint life policy. So what we'll be dealing is that we'll be mentioning a specific illustration for you and will guide you what happens if plan A is followed, what happens if plan B is followed. Now you'd be wondering what is plan A and what is plan B. Plan A is where the joint life policy is maintained at the exact level, and plan B is if the joint life policy is maintained at the surrender level in the balance sheet. That means if X amount is the value of the joint life policy, if that same X amount is referring in the balance sheet, then it's at the neutral level. But if X amount is the value of the joint life policy, and if you're figuring it out as Y, that means if you're figuring it at Y at a lower value as compared to the joint life policy in the balance sheet, then what is the effect of it? So let's figure that out. Now we have an illustration for your reference here. We have A, B and C who share profit and ratio or profit and loss in the ratio of 5:3:2. They took a joint life policy of 1 lakh rupees here, and the same appears in the balance sheet at the surrender value of rupees 10,000. That means they took a joint life policy of 1 lakh and the same is appearing in the balance sheet at a surrender value which is mentioned as 10,000. Now what happens if at the date of the maturity, if it is mentioned at surrender value and if it is not mentioned at surrender value, what is the benefit that we earn here is something that we'll be understanding. So the first thing is that whether in this case the retirement happens or death. Now we are absolutely talking about death, so death is the case here. Now this question mentions that understand in case if A dies, then what is the effect of it? So that's what we'll be understanding here. The first entity that we'll be passing when A dies is the maturity amount that we're supposed to get. That means 1 lakh rupees. So bank account debit to joint life policy account, which is mentioned as 1 lakh rupees here. Now there are two scenarios what you have to deal with. If in case, if this was mentioned at a 10% or rather a surrender value, that is 10,000, and if the same thing was mentioned as 1 lakh in the balance sheet, the game is all over this. Whether you're mentioning this, the same thing in the balance sheet as 10,000 or 1 lakh. So there is a massive difference what we'll be understanding with these journal entries that we'll be passing right now. So the first case that we'll be dealing here is what happens if the same thing is mentioned at the surrender value. That means when we understand that surrender value has been mentioned in the balance sheet, the value of the joint life policy is 1 lakh, but we have shown it as 10,000. That means whenever the policy receive, we're receiving additional 90,000 as a profit part. So what happens to that? Because the actual policy is 10,000 as mentioned in the balance sheet, but the actual value of the policy is 1 lakh. So whenever we are receiving 90,000 addition to it. So what happens to that 90,000 is what we'll be understanding here. So if you can see, 10,000 has been already mentioned as a surrender value. That means that is supposed to be given. 90,000 that we are receiving is an additional profit. So that profit is supposed to be divided in the ratio of 5:3:2 to individual partners, and that is what we have done here. Now what happens if this same thing is mentioned as 1 lakh in the balance sheet? We'll be getting 1 lakh, but that will be divided in the ratio of 5:3:2 again. That means in addition to this, it will be termed as 50,000 for A, 30,000 for B, and 20,000 for C. So if you can see the difference between the payments that we are making towards individual partners' capital as a firm, there is a massive difference. In the first case, we pay 45,000 to A's capital. That means 5,000 less if it is not mentioned at surrender value. Accordingly, 3,000 less for B and 2,000 less for C. So this is the difference if you're mentioning it at the surrender value and if you're not mentioning it at the surrender value. So I hope this video gives you a lot of clarity about how to deal with special transactions when it is related to joint life policy and what happens or what the journal entries are supposed to be passed whenever you understand that under this special transaction where a joint life policy is supposed to be considered at the death of the partner case, JLP basically, joint life policy, is dealt in such a manner, and the two scenarios where if the plan A states that the joint life policy has been mentioned at surrender value in the balance sheet, and the second if the joint life policy isn't mentioned in the balance sheet or at all not mentioned at the surrender value, then what are the scenarios that you have to deal with has been mentioned here. So I believe this video gave you a clarity about what are the journal entries that we have to pass and how they have to deal with. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.